this is the face of the future in German Touring Car Championship, the Deutsche Tourenwagen Meisterschaft. This is the C-Class Mercedes, which we saw on Eurosport in its wind tunnel tests at the end of last year. Now the car's been rolled out. They've started testing already, and after more wind tunnel work on the aerodynamics, the first real practice session at Estoril in Portugal. Months ago, this car was the hottest car in motorsport, the new 190 Mercedes. It's old-fashioned already, though. Here is the new car, the C-Class car, with Mercedes' first V6 racing engine in recent times. ABS brakes, active suspension, traction control, everything that Mercedes-Benz can throw at it. Everything, in fact, except four-wheel drive, which is what they were beaten by in the 93 championship by Alfa Romeo. This, though, is the car which Mercedes is convinced will take them to victory in the 1994 series. Klaus Ludwig, 92 German champion. Alan Law and Bernd Schneider. The drivers down here, Roland Asch, the fourth member of the factory team. Carried out the initial testing at Malsheim, former airfield circuit, but he's not down at Estoril this weekend. Here it is, the Mercedes, the C-Class, brand new. A huge amount of development work on it, and just listen to that V6 engine.
Ja gut, das ist für den Fahrer natürlich unheimlich wichtig. Das ist genau wie in jedem anderen
Klaus
Sport
Ludwig
auch.
Tells
je mehr man fährt, je fitter bleibt man, je mehr ist man dran gewöhnt. Man fährt nachher auf einer Rennstrecke rum, als würden sie
zu Hause zur Arbeit fahren.
Natürlich ist das dann. Ich meine, dafür ist das unheimlich wichtig. Das neue Auto ist halt eben noch sehr, sehr neu und hat halt eben noch
in practice and get used to racing the car. The car is very new. There's a lot of question marks. We have a lot to do. We don't just drive 30 laps and go for it, but we do 3 or 4. Then we do some work on it. The drivers talk with the mechanics and the engineers. We look at the electronics. We change this and that. Find a better way of adjusting the suspension or the engine power band.
So arbeitet man sich langsam zu einem Punkt,
really
wo
man sagt,
jetzt sind wir eigentlich zufrieden, jetzt könnten wir eigentlich mal eine Renndistanz fahren. Und dann
just like Formula One now, says Klaus, it's an enormous amount of work. Well, for Ellen Law, not an easy session. She's never been at Estoril before and even more importantly, she has never used a sequential gearbox, which is another innovation for Mercedes here in the 1994 championship. So she had a lot of work to do before she came to Estoril.
Well,
I've never been here, said the first lady of German motorsport. I only knew the circuit from the plans I'd seen. So in the last couple of days, I've been training my head to drive with a sequential gearbox around a circuit that I didn't know, in a gearbox I didn't know either. I had to pay a lot of attention because you pull for up gears and you push for down gears. As I'm used to normal gearboxes, there's always a risk I'm going to go from second to first instead of second to third. Once you got used to it, Ellen could start to really enjoy the 400 horsepower from this new V6 engine.
Also grundsätzlich haben wir natürlich schon ein ganz
schönes Schüppchen. You don't notice immediately the difference between the old and new engines. It's just perhaps a few more horsepower, but the really big difference is the new engine is much easier to drive.
Hat der
a much wider usable rev band.
And
the engine revs incredibly fast. You just have to change gears so quickly.
Denn dieses Ding packt einfach überall an und das ist unheimlich angenehm. Das heißt, man kann durchaus jetzt auch ein bisschen untertourig durch eine Ecke fahren, um das Fahrzeug zu stabilisieren, was auch immer.
The question of getting used to the sequential box and really she said,
hoch, das ist ganz enorm und das macht wahnsinnig viel Spaß.
It's been quite a learning curve for me here. The opposition this year in the DTM, including Alpha, with their 155 V6 TIs, which this year will have ABS braking, and at mid-season we'll have TAG McLaren active suspension, already of course four-wheel drive, and Alpha running up to 8 cars in the DTM this year, Mercedes 4 factory cars and a number of second string cars. Opel, of course, coming in with the Calibra, run by Just Racing for Keke Rosberg and Manuel Reuter. Added to that, all the BMW and Mercedes privateers. Well, over the 2 days, Lohr, Ludwig and Bernd Schneider made a lot of progress, did a lot of testing on the Estoril circuit to get the car as perfect as possible, with the mechanics never stopping for a moment. After 2 days of it, the Mercedes people were pretty happy. The Class C had improved a lot in 48 hours, but there's still a lot of work to do to be ready for the first race on the 10th of April at Zolder. We took the chance to talk to Norbert Haug, Mercedes Motorsport Chief.
Der Zeitplan ist der, dass wir in 10 Wochen eigentlich ein rennfertiges
Auto haben
wollen.
Car.
Wir haben noch 10 Wochen Zeit.
In 10 weeks, he said.
Wir haben von den runden Seiten
lap times we made here in Estoril.
Ganz viel
well, they're getting close to what we want, but we still got to drive,
fahren.
Mit unserem the 190, we could race 150 laps at Estoril, 1,000 kilometers almost, without having any problems. And that's what we're going to have to achieve with this new car, just to make sure it's going to be absolutely reliable.
Möglichst schnell mit dem neuen Auto diesen Standard erreichen.